Hello and good evening. This is the Daily News Podcast. I'm Navya Singh and here are the most important news that deserve your attention today. Let's get started. The human trial of COVID-19 vaccine candidate developed by the University of Oxford has shown a positive result. The vaccine has prompted a protective immune response in hundreds of people who got the shot. The vaccine also did not prompt any serious side effects. The researchers have said that they found their experimental COVID-19 vaccine produced a dual immune response in people aged between the years 18 to 55. The potential vaccine is already in large-scale phase 3 human trials to assess whether it can protect COVID-19. In the phase 3, it will be tested on about 30,000 people in the United States alone. 2 days after a news agency cited the chairperson of Indian Medical Association, Dr. V.K. Monga, saying that community transmission of COVID-19 has begun in India, the IMA has now issued a clarification and said that the statement is not from its headquarters and should be considered a matter of personal opinion. In its official statement, the body said that it is for the official authorities to ascertain this stage. In another major news, the Health Ministry on Monday warned against the inappropriate use of N95 masks, especially those that contain respiratory valves. Director General of Health Services Rajiv Garg encouraged people to use homemade face masks. In a letter addressed to all the states and union territories, the Director General mentioned that the N95 masks is detrimental to the measures adopted for preventing the spread of coronavirus as it does not prevent the virus from escaping out of the mask. Shifting focus to Assam, 6 more people have lost their lives in the flood-related incidents in Assam, taking the death toll to 85 in the state. Assam Chief Minister has informed that over 70 lakh people have been affected due to the Assam floods. He also said that the state on one hand is troubled due to COVID-19 and on the other hand is facing challenges arising out of the Assam floods. According to the World Meteorological Organization, locust attacks are posing a serious threat to food security in parts of East Africa, Pakistan, and India as a result of changing climatic conditions that can be linked to human activity. The agency of the United Nations has said that extreme weather events and climatic changes provide a new environment for pest breeding, development, and migration. Large and aggressive swarms of crop-devouring short-horned insects recently invaded over 24 districts of desert areas in Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh and Gujarat. That's all for today. I'll be back with some more important news tomorrow. Till then, stay safe, stay logical.